Hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Denny. If you are brand new, thank you for stopping in. If you're an oldie but goodie, welcome back. Today I have my empties for the month of January. I have quite a big bin, and as you guys know, at the end of the video I always give my totals, and we are aiming to get to $6,000 used for this year. So let's see how we're doing so far the month of January. I'm just gonna dive right on in and grab things randomly, because if I were to take it out by sections, this video would be even longer than it already is. So let's go ahead and start with the first item that I am pulling out is from Bolero, and it's a serum milk. This one right here is in licorice root and watermelon, and I will have to say that this is something that I'm going to pass for the next time, just because I do not like the scent of the licorice in this. The serum itself worked, it felt fine, but the smell, I just can't get over it. It's something that I do not like, so I will not be picking this up. I'm very honest with you guys. When it's something that I love, I let you know. When it's something that I hate, I also let you know. The next thing that I have in my bin is from Dr. Brandt, and it's their Clean Biotic facial cleanser. It's a yogurt cleanser. This I absolutely loved, and I would love to use this in the future again. I do not currently have a backup of this, but I definitely would get this in the future. But at the moment, I have a bunch of cleansers that I'm going through, so I'm not gonna repurchase at the moment, but I would definitely repurchase in the future. Next item that I have is the Brazilian Bum Bum. This is from Sol de Janeiro. It is a body butter. I ended up using this complete pot up. I absolutely love the scent of this. It is so good. Actually, it just burped up the scent. It smells so great. I absolutely love this lotion, this body butter, and I would definitely get it time and time again, just because the scent feels so good, and also it makes your skin super soft. It's a yes. I have several vitamin products that I am going to show you guys, and with this I give you a disclaimer. These are vitamins and supplements that I take, but that doesn't mean that they would function the same for you guys, but I want to tell you how I feel about them. So the first one is from VitaFusion, and it's the melatonin. I take melatonin every single night because it is really hard for me to sleep during this time. Like, quarantine has really changed my sleep pattern, and this one right here, I don't like these gummies particularly. I don't like the way they feel. Like, if it's left open, they get really hard really quickly. And I don't think this is a brand that I'm going to continue to get. There is another one that I do like, but I can't remember which one that was. These I get as a last resort. They're like the cheaper ones. So, I mean, I'm not saying that I'm altogether saying that I will never get them again, but they're not my preferred ones. Next up, I have another melatonin type of supplement. This one is from Ollie, and it's the Sleep. This one I really did like. I like the way this gummy tastes. You do get less in here. Like, the one with the VitaFusion, you get 100 of them. This one you only get 50. I went through this really, really quickly, and the reason why there's so many is because both my husband and I both take them, so they go really quickly. So this one has this blackberry taste, which I do like, and I actually picked up another one from this brand that I like a little bit better, and I guess you'll be seeing that one in the next empties, but I do prefer this one instead. Another supplement that I use is the biotin. I love using biotin to grow my hair, to help me have, you know, just stronger, you know, skin, hair, nails, all that stuff. You know, it's all combined in biotin. So this one also is a gummy formula. I prefer the gummy formula just because they're just easy for me to pop in and just chew them, and then I forget about them. If they were pill form, I don't think I would be inclined to actually use them. I don't recommend gummy form for all vitamins because it's not good for you to be eating a ton of gummies, but I have on occasion, just because it's just easier for me. This one I really like, and it's my preferred biotin gummy, so I would definitely get this one again. I went through a bunch of perfume samples, and I'm gonna show you most of them, I think, at once. So the first one that I have in my hand is My Way. This one smelled pretty good. It's from Giorgio Armani. It's not something that I would go out and buy a full bottle of it, but I did enjoy it. Then I have the Victor and Rolf. This one is the Flower Bomb. I really like the way this smells, and I would actually get a full bottle of this one. And then we have Black Opium by Yves Saint Laurent. And this one I already have a full bottle of back there. So yeah, you'll see this. This next item that I have here is from Benefit, and it's the Professional. This is a primer. I really like this primer, and I definitely will be using it again in the future. I do own another full size, so you will be seeing this in the future again. Then I have a Milk mascara. This one is the Kush mascara by Milk Makeup, and it's the mini. I do not like this mascara at all. It was not good for my eyes. It made me itch a whole lot. There's something in this formula that does not work out for me, and it's a shame. I have a full size of this, and I'm scared to even open it just because of the way this one made me feel. I don't think I would be using it. The next item that I have is from Clarins, and it's a eye treatment. This one is the Concentrate Zone Regard, and it's supposed to be super restorative total eye care. So this you put under your eyes to help smooth out any, you know, wrinkles. Also helps with darkness under your eye and things like that. I do enjoy this, and I enjoy this brand a whole lot. So I would definitely see this in the future, but at the moment I have other things that I'm going through again, so I'm just gonna go through those. I have another one from Clarins. This is a serum, and this is the Photo Tensure. I don't know how to say that, but it's a extra firming tightening lift botanical serum. And this one, again, I really like Clarins, but I don't see myself purchasing any new serums at the moment. Then I have here from Origins. This is an eye treatment as well. This one I did not like. There's something in the Origins formula that I do not like for my skin texture and my face, and under the eye I felt like it was not working out for me. So this is one that I will not be getting. Oh, I totally forgot about this. I received in my Walmart box a sample of the My Bite vitamins, and these are vitamins that are actually like little chocolates, and they taste good, and I felt fine with them. They didn't have like a vitamin taste, but as you can see on the back of this package, they have a lot of different vitamins in here. They have one for Multi-Her Energy, a multivitamin, and a calcium one. I think that is a really cool option for people who don't like taking any pills or don't like gummies, to have like a option that's chocolate. Who doesn't like eating chocolate, you know? So this was cool, and in the future I would probably try this out for longer than just like one try. I would like to get a bottle and try it for a longer time. I went through a full foundation from the L'Oreal Infallible. This one is my number one favorite type of foundation. This one I get in the shade 425 for my skin tone. I love this foundation, and I already purchased a new one of it. And then I also tried out a sample of the Tarte Found Sealer. So this one was fine. I think this was the one that I really did like as well. It has a really creamy feeling to it, and it's full coverage, so I would definitely pick up the Tarte Found Sealer. And then I ended up testing out the Huda Beauty foundation in Custard, and this one was in the 220. I think the color was too dark, and it oxidized on me, and it just made me look like I had darker patches of skin. So I didn't really like this formula. Also, it dried really quickly on my skin and made my skin feel and look dry, so I wouldn't pick this one up. As for the Found Sealer one, I used the Light Medium Honey 29H, if you were just interested. We got several soaps, a lot of hand soaps. So I have two of the Dial hand soaps. These right here were limited edition scents in the Tropical Breeze. Really like this. I would definitely get hand soap over and over and over again. We need it in my house. I'd say we used a lot of them, and this is me and my husband. So the soft soap we also got, this one is a good one in the White Tea and Berry, and then another one in the Fresh Breeze, and this one I've talked about before. I liked it. And then my husband ended up testing out this lavender bouquet one from a Lucky brand that he found at the dollar store, and he said that he liked this one as well. I did not try this one out, so I think on the next go around I will test it out, because I'm sure we have some more of them in my house. And then last but not least, I spoke about this one saying that I hated it. It's the spa soap, and I also got this at the dollar store. It's a giant jug of just like really liquidy, watery soap. Don't like it. Don't recommend it. Stay away from it. I also have one of the body washes that I always talk about. Not gonna linger on this one. It's just a body wash from Arm & Hammer. Gonna leave it at that. I also have a feminine wash. This one I got at the dollar store, just testing it out. It's supposed to be compared to Summer's Eve. I felt that it was okay. It's not my favorite, and I think it's because I have other ones that are just much better than this. But on an occasion where I just need something really quickly, I end up getting this. So yeah, it's an option. As for moisturizer, I ended up finishing up the Drunk Elephant's Proteiny Peptide Cream. So this one, I ended up finishing this jar. Really, really, really enjoyed this moisturizer. It felt really great on my skin, and I would definitely use this again. I know this is a very expensive brand, so we will see. We will see if we will have this again, but at the moment I have a bunch of moisturizers, so I'm not worried. Then we have another serum that I use. This one is from Caudalie, and it's the Vino Perfect. This one I did not like. I had to force myself to use this serum. It was not working out for my skin, and also I kept breaking out during the time that I was using this. I don't know if it was this or a combination of all the products that I was using at the same time, but this in general, every time that I used it, it made my skin really like rashy, and I just didn't like it. Then next I have another serum or concentrate. This one is from Shiseido. Really enjoyed this one. It smells like their signature Shiseido scent. And I did like this, and I would love to have things like this in the future. I know that I'm gonna just use what I have, but definitely enjoyed it. Next, I have another facial primer. This one is from The Balm, and it's the Time Bomb. I really like this, and I have another one waiting for me to use it, but I'm using something at the moment, but I really like this one. So this one's a yes. I have here from Pixi. This is the Pixi Makeup Fixing Mist. This is in rose. I like the scent. I just don't like the spray. I don't like this sprayer. It just shot out at you. It didn't like mist finely, and it's supposed to be a mist. So when you mist, it's supposed to just like fall all over really nice and smooth. This one was just like spitting at you really hard, aggressively hurting your face. So honestly, I don't know if that really changed my view of the product, but it's something that I'm not gonna get in the future. Got to use a bunch of samples and things that I had in my drawer, one of them being from Cantu, and it's the leave-in conditioner. This one I like the way it felt on my hair. I don't see myself buying this again, just because I have my preferred leave-ins and things like that. So did I like it? Yes, but will I get it again? No. Then I ended up trying out from Pureology this set of shampoo and conditioner. This one is supposed to be for colored treated hair. And one thing that I didn't like about this that other people would probably love and benefit from is that it has like a tingly sensation, like a minty sensation when you use it on your head. I do not like that sensation. So for me, this was not my type of shampoo. Anytime something just makes my head tingle, I don't like it. It feels like just caffeine to the head. No thank you. But I know a lot of people do enjoy that type of feeling, so if you do, this is one for you. Then I tested out this Garnier Fructis, the falling breaking hair one. I don't know, it's supposed to fight your hair from falling out. I don't see that it had a big difference. It's not like their usual Garnier Fructis formula. It was fine, but it's not something that I would get and use, so it was okay. And then another hair sample again. This one was from Suave, and it's the Natural Fusions. This one had ginger and honeysuckle in it. It was fine. What I find wrong with these is that a lot of these say that they're natural, but then they have ingredients in them that actually break your hair. So I don't know. Yeah, I'm not gonna be getting this one. Then next we have the Earth Supply. This was a hair treatment mask and it's supposed to have 25% shea butter, no sulfates, silicones, or parabens in it. It felt fine on my hair and it worked really good. I got two uses out of this, which I really enjoyed. So I would definitely check it out in the future. But again, I have my favorites, so I won't be using this anytime soon. Another eye treatment, this one is from Lancôme and is the Retina Lift. I don't know if I'm saying that right or not, but it's supposed to be an eye cream. And this one I ended up using up. I loved it and would definitely want to get more of this. It was really good. I breathe really heavy when it's something that I like and I know that I'm gonna miss because it's just like that sigh of like, when will I see you again? And then next up, I have something from Estee Lauder. This one is a serum in the Night Advanced Repair. It says Night Repair, and it's supposed to be a serum you use at night, but I use this both day and night, and I loved it. Absolutely loved using it both times of the day. It wasn't too thick or anything like that. It was just like a perfect serum for me. So I would definitely use this again. I actually have another one of these in my drawer, so that will be getting used at some point this year. But yes, we have this. Next up, I have a small face wash from Origins. This one had a peppermint feeling in it. This one is their Checks and Balance Frothy Face Wash. It had like a mintiness to it, which was fine. It didn't affect my face or anything like that. My face did feel a little bit drier or tight after I washed with this, so I did have to moisturize a bit more. But other than that, it felt fine. It's not something that I'm gonna run out to purchase, but it didn't make me break out, so we have that. Next, I have another face mist. This one is a tiny sample size bottle of the LA Colors Hydrating Face Mist in Coconut. I really enjoyed this face mist. It worked out really well, and these little sprayers just spray really, really well compared to other ones that I've used. So, do I feel that I would purchase this in the future? I think you get such a little amount for the price that I don't think it's worth purchasing, but the product inside feels good. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna be purchasing these again unless they make a larger bottle and then I would purchase it or consider purchasing it. But I did enjoy it. How this happens, I don't know, but apparently I used 7 sets of nails in the month of January and I honestly don't remember using that many. And it's just crazy to me. And actually, these are coming off because I just lost one as I was filming this video. One just popped off. So, we have from Sassy and Chic, which is one of my favorite types of brands, even though one of my favorite types of brands for the price of it. These I get at the dollar store, like I always say. So, I have 3 of these. Then I ended up trying another one of the LA Colors. These are excellent, I love them. Also, these Nailicious ones, they're a Canadian brand and they are awesome. Definitely recommend them. And then the Smart Girl ones, they also were really good and they're a Canadian brand as well. Or I think I've only seen them in Canada. And then the last set of nails, which is the ones that I have on, are the Doris nails. And these were really nice, except for the fact that they have glue on them already. They're pre-glued. I wish that they didn't have the glue because that's what makes them fall off. And I literally put these on last night and they are already falling off. So I don't recommend the glue on them, but I do think the nails are pretty. Ended up using some bars of soap. Actually, I had 2 of these Caress ones. Just love the smell of this soap, and I used it when we were traveling. And I just like taking bar soap instead of liquid soap when I travel. It's just easier to travel with. And then this one right here, Dove Men's Care that my husband gets, and yeah, he likes this one. So these were fine. You'll see these again possibly if I travel. I just always get bar soap. A box of tissues. If you don't know, I always like break my boxes just because they take up a lot of space. And tissues. Yeah, you're gonna see tissues again. A must have missed these perfumes. So I ended up going through a bottle of the 212 Carolina Herrera. This right here comes with two of them, two spray bottles. And you'll notice that this one has a little bit of liquid in them, inside of it. But this one, for some reason, the sprayer is not working anymore. And I tried to put it under water, like hot water, to just make it loose again so that it can spray, and it's not. So I'm guessing that something on the inside is just like clogged and it's not letting the perfume come out. So we did go through this, and then I ended up using a sample of the Mon Paris by Yves Saint Laurent. And I really like this one as well. Oh my goodness, love these perfumes. I would definitely get this one in the future. This one, I think I'll hold off. I don't know that this is still around. Maybe it is, I don't know. Interestingly enough, we don't have any toothpaste, but we do have some tooth items. So right here I have my Burst, the head to my Burst. I use the Burst Oral Care toothbrush, and this is the head that goes attached to it. It's a charcoal one. I really like this system. It works out really well for me, and you get a new one of these every 3 months, I think, that they send them to you, or if you do like your subscription, they will send them to you as often as you want them. So I have this one and I really enjoy it. And then I have here, this is a Steripod. It's what I use to cover my toothbrush when it's sitting out on the counter. I don't like anything to get on it, so I use the Steripod. It's just like a little like clamp that goes over it that keeps it from getting germs inside. These usually come in a 2-pack, but those are some tooth items. I have a small sample of this Arul. It's a water type of serum, emollient, I don't know. Use this, it was fine. I have a bunch of products from that brand that I think I need to do a review on. Then we have a hand sanitizer from the Crumb Shop. This one is in mixed berries. I like the idea of the pouch, but you don't get a lot of it in here. You go through them really quickly. And they have another formula that's like a spray bottle, and I like that a little bit more. You get, I think, three of these in the box for, I don't know, like about $6. I don't think it's worth it, but definitely fun to use. Then I have a candle. We talked about candles the last time. We have this one, which is from Bath & Body Works. It's the flannel scent. I absolutely love flannel. That's my favorite scent. Went through it, actually depotted it, took out, what I do is like I take out the whatever's left at the end and I melt it down and make little like solid pieces so that I could put them in candle melters and I can just continue using up the fragrance. But just me opening this, I can smell the candle and it smells so good. So this is definitely one I recommend. Oh, and I misspoke. I have another box of nails that I use in the month of January. So that's 8. This one is also from LA Colors. I think what happens is that I put them on and then I get tired of looking at the same color. I take them off and I pop on a new one and I don't even notice. went through some wipes for the face. This Bolero 32 count of wipes. Really like when they come with 32 because that's a little bit more than what the other ones come with. And these feel fine. They work out with me. Then Global Beauty Care, I got this pack of 30. This was actually pretty good too. When I get 30, I'm happy. That's a good amount of wipes. This last one is from Wet n Wild. You only get 10 wipes in here. This is waste. They all cost the same amount of money. So I would definitely pick up the bigger value because it just makes sense to me. Then I have here a hair mask that I did actually last night from L'Oreal Paris. It's the Ever Pure Sulfate Free Deep Moisturizing Hair Mask. This one comes with like a little bonnet that you put on and you sit your hair in there after you wash it. And it has like all of the cream or moisturizer conditioning treatment in there. And you massage it into your head and leave it on for I think 15 minutes or so. Wait. How long were you supposed to leave it on? I think here it says leave it on for 5 minutes. I left it on for like 15 minutes because I didn't pay attention to that. But my hair felt super, super soft after I did it, and it felt really great. And I was able to do my hair with no troubles today. And yeah, hair masks like that, even if they say 5 minutes, I always extend the time. And I actually really like this. I would definitely pick this up again. And more of them, actually, because anything that helps my hair feel smoother, love it. Now we're at the mask portion of my video, which I always leave for the last. This time around, I don't have as many as I normally do, but I do have a bunch. I ended up using a lot of eye gels. This one was from Spa Life, and it's a hydrogel under eye patch one. This one was good. I have one from Tolly Moly. This one was the Vita C hydrogel, and it had minions on it. This one broke and fell apart, so I'm gonna say no for this, but it was super cute. I just can't justify cuteness with like it not working. Then we have one from Skin Camp, and this is the Magic Eyes Collagen Hydrogel. This one was great. From Holler and Glow, we have the Money Honey, and this one was also really good. We have the Shang Pri Gold Eye Pearl Mask. This one was good. From Nature Love, and it's a rose petal one, also good. We have an excellent mask by Vita Mask. This one was great. I have one from Face Story. It's the Everyday Charcoal. This one was also really great. One from Creme Shop, and this was the CBD. I find that I really enjoy CBD items on my face, so I love that. From Miss Spa, we have the Bamboo Charcoal one, also great. Tried this guy out. This is from a brand called Designed by Mind, Body, and Soul, and it was a llama one. It was fine. I don't think I want to give it a full thumbs up or full thumbs down. I think it was just like fine. You know, I find that there's other ones that are a lot better. This one dried up pretty quickly. Then we have a lip patch mask, and this one is from Soe. I really like these a whole lot. Taste Beauty, we have the Make Waves. It was a mermaid one. It was, again, fine. I'm gonna give it a thumbs in the middle. I find that there's other ones that are really great and some that are a little bit more drying. Then we have this one from Global Beauty Care. It was the multivitamin one. Again, this one was fine. From 111 Skin, we have another eye mask. This one was excellent. I really like this one. Then we have here from the Mask Bar. This was a nose treatment to take out like your blackheads. And this one did not remove a whole lot, but it was really cute. So I'm gonna say like right in the middle. Like if you have to do what you say you're gonna do. That's the thing. And then we have this mask from Kala, which was excellent. It was a biocellulose one, and it also came with a serum. Love that. And we have another eye mask. This was a pack of three, and these are good as well. That was everything that was inside of my empties for the month of January. Gosh, it was like a whole lot. I'm hoping that this video isn't like 3 hours long. But in any case, here are my totals. So for the month of January, my ending total was $593.27 of products used. That is a great start to push us in to this year. And like I said before, my goal is to use $6,000 worth of products. I'm trying not to bring in a lot of new things and just focus on the things that I have currently. However, the dollar store has really made it really difficult for me to not shop for certain things because they're bringing a ton of skincare. So that is probably going to be one of my next videos. Go ahead, subscribe if you haven't done so, and keep up with me so that you can see everything that I'm up to. Become a member of my Guns fam, and as always, from my house to yours. Love ya.